Two U.S. strategic bombers conducted drills over South Korea on Thursday, the U.S. Air Force said, raising tensions with North Korea just days before President Donald Trump visits the region seeking to shut down Pyongyang's nuclear program. News of the drills was first reported by North Korean state news agency KCNA on Friday, which said the exercises involving South Korean and Japanese fighter jets were a surprise nuclear strike drill. Trump arrives in Asia on Sunday, beginning his first trip to the region as president in Japan before heading to South Korea and China, then Vietnam and the Philippines. A series of missile tests by North Korea and its sixth and largest nuclear test have fueled the most critical international challenge of Trump's presidency. As the situation escalates, in this video, Defense Updates analyzes why North Korea must fear the Trident II missile of the United States.
Number 5.
The UGM-133A Trident II, or Trident D-5, is a submarine-launched ballistic missile, SLBM, built by Lockheed Martin Space Systems in Sunnyvale, California, and deployed with the American and British navies. It was first deployed in March of 1990 and remains in service. The Trident II strategic weapons system is an improved SLBM with greater accuracy, payload, and range than the earlier Trident I. It's a key element of the U.S. strategic nuclear triad. Nuclear triad is the ability to launch strategic nuclear weapons from land, sea, and air. The missile was developed to strengthen the U.S. strategic deterrence.
Number 4.
Trident II was designed to be more advanced than Trident I, which was retired in 2005. It has greater range and payload capacity. It's accurate enough to be used as a first strike weapon. The Trident II is a three-stage rocket, each stage containing a solid fuel rocket motor. The first stage is made by Thiokol and Hercules Incorporated. This first stage incorporates a solid propellant motor, parts to ensure first stage ignition, and a thrust vector control (TVC) system. The first and second stage motors are connected by an interstage casing, which contains electronic equipment and ordnance for separation during flight. The second stage also contains a motor made by Thiokol and Hercules Incorporated, parts to ensure the second stage ignition and a TVC system. The second and third stage sections are connected by an integrated equipment adapter section, ES. The third stage contains critical guidance and flight control avionics, such as the Mark 6 navigation system. This stage also contains the TVC system, ordnance for ejecting from the second stage motor, and the MIRV platform. The nose fairing shields the payload and third stage motor. The missile is 13.579 meters in length, 2.11 meters in diameter, and weighs in at 130,000 pounds, or 59,000 kilograms. It's reinforced by carbon fiber and Kevlar to maximize strength-to-weight ratio.
Number 3.
Trident II missiles are carried by 14 U.S. Ohio-class submarines. The 14 ballistic missile submarines of Ohio-class together carry approximately 50% of the total U.S. active inventory of strategic thermonuclear warheads. The Ohio-class submarines is the largest submarines ever built for the U.S. Navy, having a displacement of 16,764 tons. The Soviet-designed Typhoon-class submarines have more than twice the total displacement, and Russia's Bory-class submarines have roughly 25% greater displacement than Ohio, but the Ohio-class boats carry more missiles than either. 24 Trident missiles apiece versus 16 by the Bory-class, 20 by the Bory II, and 20 by the Typhoon class. Ohio class is nuclear powered and hence it has unlimited range, constrained only by food supply. Since submarine-based nuclear weapons tend to be the least vulnerable and therefore these are best suited for second strike missions. This is what makes Trident II a deadly weapon. It is virtually impossible to neutralize the missiles with a preemptive strike. The Trident is so efficient that even next generation of U.S. and U.K. submarines will field them. The Ohios are forecast to move out of service between 2027 and 2040, but the incoming Columbia class, the first vessels of which is scheduled to enter service in 2031, will continue to deploy the Trident 2, and a common missile compartment designed to house the missiles will be a feature of both the Columbia design and the incoming British Dreadnought-class submarines, which will begin to replace the current UK Vanguard class from 2028.
Number 2.
Trident 2 missile has a speed of approximately Mach 24 or 8,060 meters per second in terminal phase. The missile has a range of more than 7,500 miles or 12,000 kilometers. This range enables the missile to be launched from far off from the target. There have been 161 successful test flights of the Trident 2 missile since design completion in 1989, the most recent being from the USS Maryland in August of 2016, clearly demonstrating the dependability and readiness of the missile. The missile has an accuracy of 90 meters, making it one of the most accurate long-range strategic missiles in the world.
Number 1.
The Trident 2 is multiple independent reentry vehicle, MIRV, capable, and hence can carry multiple warheads, with each warhead being assigned to a different target. It can be configured with two types of MIRV. The Mark V MIRV can carry up to 14 W88 475 kiloton warheads, while the Mark IV MIRV having the ability to carry 14 W76 100 kiloton warheads. To give viewers a perspective, Little Boy atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima had a yield of 15 kilotons of TNT, and Fat Man atomic bomb that was detonated over Nagasaki had a yield of 21 kilotons of TNT. New START, Strategic Arms Reduction Treaty, between the United States and the Russian Federation agreed on having only 8 warheads per missile, so currently Trident 2 has MIRV with 8 warheads. A full salvo from an Ohio-class submarine, which can be launched in less than 1 minute, could unleash up to 24 Trident 2 missiles, each with 8 warheads. In other words, 192 nuclear warheads in total. This is enough to obliterate huge portion of the Earth's landmass.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.